This Safer Internet Day, we are calling out to everyone to help take action against online hate and how we can make the internet a better and kinder place.
It is important that we know what to do when we see hate online.
It is, so that's why we're here with Steve today, to help us learn more about when online hate becomes a crime.
Steve is a policeman working with the UK Safer Internet Centre.
So what is a hate crime?
Okay, so it's probably easy to start off with a non-hate crime. So we'll take something like criminal damage. Imagine that you've fallen out with your friends, you're really angry about it, so you decide to pick up a rock or a stone and go and throw it through their window. That would be criminal damage. Now imagine that you're going to do that same thing, but this time the reason you're throwing that rock through a window isn't because you have fallen out with someone, it's because they're different. Maybe they're disabled, maybe they've got a different religion to you, maybe they've got a different race to you, maybe they're gay. And that's your motivation behind it, yeah? You throw that rock because they're different. That would make it a hate crime. Criminal damage, but a hate crime.
So how does hate crime come about online?
So online, you'll be looking at other sort of crimes, so things like maybe you just really don't like someone, so you're giving them lots of verbal abuse, lots of threats online, things like that. So we would call that malicious communications. But again, if you're doing that because someone's different, it would become a hate crime. Or maybe you're just bombarding someone with message after message after message. You're really harassing them, but if you're doing it again because they're different, that would be a hate crime.
What should we do if we see it, or it happens to myself, or Harvey, or yourself?
So it's really important you have to tell someone. These crimes can make you feel isolated, they can make you feel lonely, they can make you feel really, really bad about yourself. So it's really important you need to talk to someone, and then that person can help and guide you about doing the right thing, which is obviously report it. Yeah. That's the most important thing you can do.
How do we know if it breaks the law?
That's really difficult because every single one of those is different. But the person you trust that you've gone to can help you and support you. Go to the police, ask them, and they will be able to assist you. And even if it isn't breaking the law as a crime, it could still be a hate incident, and they have specially trained officers that can help.
Thanks, Steve. So remember, all the ways to report a hate crime or advice or help will be on the website. Get involved with a social media campaign to hashtag share a heart and make the internet full of kindness and R-E-S-P-E-C-T.